Today's yoga class is about concentration. We're going to be doing a lot of balance poses that are going to help us focus in, and we can use that both on our mats and into our lives. So we're going to start in child's pose. You can keep your knees together or you can take them apart, heels together, and rest your forehead right on the mat. Bring your arms in front of you and start to come into your breath. Take three breaths, inhaling, filling your belly up, and then exhaling, letting that breath go. Take another breath. As you breathe in, press your hands into your mat. And as you exhale, draw your hips back towards your heels. Take one more deep breath in. On your exhale, begin to walk yourself up to tabletop. Shoulders directly over your wrists and hips in line with your knees. So a little space between your knees. We'll do some cat-cows. Inhaling, drop your belly, lift your head and your hips. And then exhale, curl your spine. Look at your belly button like you're a scared cat. Again, inhale for cow. Drop your belly, lift your eyes. And then exhale, curl in and look towards your belly. Press the mat away from you. One more time for cow, inhaling. And then exhale. Good, come back to a neutral spine, that tabletop position. Reach your right hand like you're shaking hands with me or someone in front of you. Good, and then squeeze your belly towards your spine as you lift your opposite leg up. So left leg lifts, right arm reaches out. So you wanna pull your hand like you're a rubber band pulling forward and back. Good, and then just find that balance, engage your belly towards your spine. And you might wanna just look down, keeping your neck in line with your spine. Good, and then we're gonna add one more level of complexity. You're gonna flip your palm over, bend your left knee, and then reach back for your left foot. Take your foot with your hand, flex your toes, and lift your foot to the sky. So your right shoulder starts to rotate toward the ceiling. Press into your left hand, see if you can open your heart, even let your head fall back. Take another breath. And then exhale, hands to the mat, leg to the mat. Other side, inhale, left arm reaches up. And right leg reaches back. So know that sometimes it's not just the pose, it's what you learn about yourself in the pose, and falling out of a pose is just as valid and good. It means you're pushing your limits, you're challenging yourself. Flip your palm, reach back for your right foot, press your foot into your hand, heart lifts, look to the sky if you would like, or just keep your gaze down towards your front hand. Good, take another deep breath in. On your exhale, release that hand and foot to the ground. Press back into child's pose. Take a deep breath in and release. So settle yourself down, let the middle of your forehead just melt into the mat. And just pay attention to your thoughts and your feelings while you practice, and just be kind to yourself. Spread your fingers out nice and wide. We're gonna slide our chin and our chest toward our hands, coming into cobra pose. So chin, chest, and then shoulders draw up, toes into the mat, hips high. Take another breath. Exhale, curl your toes under, press your hips to the sky, spread your fingers out, shake your head yes and no, let all the tension release. Inhale, and exhale. See if you could draw your forearms to the front of the room as your tailbone lifts up a little bit more. Take one more breath. On your exhale, look forward and then slowly walk to the front of your mat. Inhale, take your hands to your shins, lift your back halfway, and then exhale, fold over your legs. One more time, inhale, halfway. From here, take your hands to your lower back, draw your elbows together, and then inhale all the way up to standing. Good, take a deep breath in as you reach up, and then hands to your heart for Tadasana. So we're gonna come into a balance pose, tree pose. So you wanna start very balanced. Lift up your left toes. Spread your toes out nice and wide. Feel the four corners of your left foot, and then spread your toes out and place them back down on the mat. You're gonna start to lift up the heel of your right foot. So the first place that heel goes is right on the ankle of the other foot. So this is position number one. If this feels good and you want to challenge yourself a little bit, you'll lift your foot up to your calf. So look down at the ground if you'd like. It's one little spot. Then if that feels right, you could take your foot and actually bring it all the way up to your upper thigh. Good. Then you can look up if you'd like, reach up and grow your tree to the sky. See if you could hold this for 3 breaths. Shoulders draw down. And if you fall, you just get back right up. Good. Take 1 more breath. And then exhale, both hands down, feet down to the ground. We're going to do the other side. So find that balance first. Spread the toes out on your right foot and then place them on the mat. Slowly start to transfer the weight onto the right foot, really rooting down on that right leg. So that right leg is nice and strong. Lifting the heel up on your left foot, drawing it to the right shin or right ankle. And then take it to the place where you feel best, where you are feeling most challenged. Good. And again, take the hands to your heart. Maybe your eyes look up. Maybe your arms reach up, or maybe not. Maybe you keep them right at mountain pose. Take 3 breaths. So you want to press your foot into your leg, and you want to resist that pressure. Take 1 more deep breath in. Exhale, hands come back to your heart. Step down. We're going to inhale, arms reach up again. And then exhale, fold over your legs. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, hands to the mat. Walk your feet back to a plank pose. Lower all the way down to your belly. Inhale, cobra again. And this time, exhale, child's pose. Good. Cross your ankles together and then roll back onto your back. So you're going to sit down and then lie all the way down. Draw your knees into your chest and rock side to side. Give your back a little massage. And then drop your knees over to the left. Open your arms nice and wide and look to the opposite side of your knees. So if your knees are to the left, you're looking to the right. Deep breath in. And release. And as you're breathing, just imagine where your body is twisting. On your exhale, draw your knees back to your chest. Rock side to side once again. And then slowly drop your knees over to the right. Open your arms wide. Look over to the left. Take a deep breath in and feel where in your body this twist is occurring. Good. Take 1 more breath. On your exhale, draw your knees back into your chest. And then very slowly extend your legs to the front of your mat. Take your hands by your side, palms facing up. Coming into Shavasana. Take a deep breath in. As you do so, count to 4. And on your exhale, see if you could extend your breath to the count of 5. Again, inhaling to the count of 4. And exhaling to the count of 5. Good. Take 1 more breath, just like this. And then let that breath go. Bend your knees, placing your feet flat on the mat. And then drop your knees over to the right side, curling up into a little ball. Take a breath here. And then on your exhale, you'll slowly come up to a seated position, crossing your legs, bringing your hands to your heart. So we can use yoga to find balance on our mats, and we can use yoga to find balance in our lives, to increase our concentration and our focus. At the end of class, we always say namaste. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you all very much.